as soon as you hit, you've got a split second then to decide how things happen from there. Either you've won the hit, you felt it, and you go, oh, I've won that. Just my body position was good, my angle, so in that second, then you work out what you do if you win that hit.
What were some of the tactics as a smaller body, someone's running at you? What were some of the things you did or learnt to do to create angles and make tackles?
I guess from a technical point of view, in the tackle, I have this belief that you got to hit hard, whether that's high, low, wherever. You got to create the impact. And how you do that is, you know, you got to get up in someone's face and all that stuff. The moment you hit, as soon as you hit, you've got a split second then to decide how things happen from there. Either you've won the hit, you felt it, and you go, oh, I've won that. Just my body position was good, my angle, my drive. So in that second, then you work out what you do if you win that hit, which is, you know, you drive forward, grips, twist, finish on top, all that stuff. But the other aspect is, for a smaller person, is a good chunk of the time when you get that hit, you'll realize straight away, I'm not going to win this. Physics, momentum, I'm not going to win this battle.
Yeah.
So that's the other half of it. And for a smaller guy, it's probably going to happen 70% of the time. If you're a bigger guy, maybe it's only going to happen 40% of the time. But working on that, so right, 70% of the time I've got the hit and I'm losing. So then how do you use that momentum, that body weight, that losing, to trick the person into doing something that you want them to do?
Yeah.
So it's very judo-ish, you know, like I've hit, they can feel they're going to win, so they're going to keep trying to dominate. If I can then use my body weight as a tripper, and use him to fall quickly or her to fall quickly. Those techniques, those sort of judo-ish techniques, you've got to actually get a hit to actually know whether you're going to go dominant or flip them passively. For me, that was really important. And I think it's a really good, simple philosophy. Get a good hit and then see what you have to do next. And then practice those skill sets.
100%. Do you think as a whole we're practicing those skill sets enough? I think about, we put a tackle bag in the middle of the field. We almost sort of coach one tackle, a dominant hit, get off the line, smash a tackle bag. They go backwards, you go forwards. Do you think we need to start coaching this stuff earlier in the piece to younger players?
Yeah, I think it is. I think one way, tackling, there's so much variety, isn't there, Rooney? So to just do one way is, yeah, you're going to miss a lot of tackles if you're just trying one way. We certainly know here in Japan, for example, there's traditionally the tackle's been taught 1980 style, just dive at ankles, and that's the style. So it does work now and then. Sometimes it can be fantastic, but a massive chunk of time, players are getting the heads on the wrong sides, they're getting knocked in the head, they're diving in any sort of footwork, and you miss.
Well, I think of it like kicking, right? You got box kick, goal kick, drop kick, grubber kick, punt kick, but then we just say tackle. Like, why can't we have different styles of tackles and have it, you know, coaching, here's a low chop, here's a higher hit, here's a dominant hit. I think we can start that conversation a lot earlier.